Changing Weather Part 1. The sun blazes the earth. The hot air blows. Come, O clouds, black clouds, get rid of the hot summer. It brings with it Diwali. The winter is amazing. Hello friends, what did you learn from this poem? So how is the weather today? Is it hot or cold? Will it rain today? We ask a lot of such questions daily. Nowadays, we learn about the weather from newspapers, radio and television. Do you know what is the weather? Come, let us try and learn about the weather from this story. The objective of this story are 1. To understand what weather is. 2. To understand the components of weather. 3. To understand how is weather forecast. Like every day, Reena and Geeta were going to school.
It is so cold today. It was so sunny in the morning and it has suddenly become so cold.
Yes, I will have to tell mother to take out some light sweaters.
The children reach school. It begins to rain after some time.
Oh, it has started to rain. Oh no, the games period will get cancelled. The rain has spoiled the whole mood.
Yes, the weather today is changing frequently. It was sunny in the morning, then it became cold, and now it has started raining.
Why does the weather change so frequently sometimes?
Now the games period will get cancelled. Come, let us go in the library and read the newspaper.
Look, there is a weather update in the newspaper. It is written here that it is expected to get cold and it could rain also. It is expected to be sunny tomorrow.
Oh, but how do they know about the forecast?
My father's friend works in the weather department. He was once telling us that the weather report is prepared by the Indian Meteorological Department. They collect data about temperature, wind from various places and prepare the report.
We had learnt last year that the sun is the primary source of energy, so the sun would have a big impact on the weather.
Come, let us prepare a list about the elements which impact the weather.
A. Sun, B. Wind.
Does rainfall also has an impact on weather?
Yes, I think like when it rains the weather changes. So rainfall does impact the weather.
The weather update in the newspaper also shows the maximum and minimum temperature. We had learnt about temperature in the chapter on heat.
Yes, the temperature is more in summers and less in winters. We had also learned that the temperature is measured through a thermometer.
This means that the following elements have an impact on the weather: sun, wind, temperature.
During summers and the rainy weather, we sweat a lot. We say that there is a lot of moisture in the air. That is the reason we sweat. I think the moisture in the air also has an impact on the weather.
Come, Geeta, let us show this list to our geography teacher. She will be able to tell us if we have made it correctly.
Hello, teacher. Today our games period was cancelled because of the rain. So Reena and I went to the library to read the newspaper. We started reading about the weather update and have prepared this list of the elements that impact the weather. Can you please tell us if these are right?
Very good. Show it to me, children. This is a correct list that you have made. These elements have an impact on the weather. Sun, wind, temperature, moisture, rainfall.
The weather update also had the maximum and minimum temperature. But when are these temperatures measured?
Children, the maximum temperatures is measured at 12 noon and the minimum in the early morning. There is a difference in the maximum and minimum temperatures of each day. Why don't both of you collect the newspapers for a week and analyze the temperature?
Teacher, we saw that there was not much change in the temperature in the week. But the humidity was more on 3 days. And there was a prediction of rain for 2 days, but it did not rain.
Yes, children, the weather changes every day and every week too. Like today's weather has changed 3 times from morning to noon.
Yes, teacher, the weather also has mood swings.
There are so many countries in the world. Some countries are close to the sea, some are in the mountains and some are deserts. Is the weather of all these different places same? Does the weather and climate gets impacted by their geographical location?
So friends, we learned about the weather. We also learned about the elements of the weather. Now if you make a plan to go out, do read about the weather update in the newspaper. Geeta asked a question that does the geographical location have an impact on the weather and climate of that region? We shall look for the answer in the next video. We shall meet soon. Weather and Climate Part 2. Hello friends. It is so hot today. It has been so sunny since morning. It seems that this year's summer is going to be harsh one. Is it hot or cold in your region? It rains heavily in some places. It is extremely cold in others. And at other places, it is very hot. Why is the weather so diverse? We had learned that the weather of a place keeps changing constantly. But if the weather of a place remains the same for many years, then it is known as climate of that place. Let us learn the difference between weather and climate through this video. Geeta and Ramesh stay in a village in Rajasthan. They are about to leave for school. Let us go to school with them. Learning objective 1. To know what is climate. 2. What is the difference between weather and climate?
Do you know Ramesh, the new girl in my class? She has come from Kerala and her name is Radha.
Oh, from Kerala.
Yes, you are right. We should help her as she is new. How are you, Radha? I was telling my brother about you. If you have any problem, please let us know.
Thank you, Geeta. I am fine. Just that it is extremely hot here.
So, wasn't it hot in Kerala?
Kerala is a coastal area. The weather there is mildly warm, but it rains a lot there. But it is very hot in Rajasthan.
Rajasthan is a desert and it is summers now. That is the reason it is very hot. It is not very hot in the winters.
Does it get cold in Kerala?
No, it is mildly warm in the winters in Kerala. It does not get cold.
There are so many different kinds of weather in one country.
Ramesh, weather gives us an idea about the temperature, rainfall and wind pattern of a few days of an area. But the weather of different places like Kerala, Rajasthan tells us about the climate of that place.
Climate. Then what is the difference between weather and climate?
Rajasthan is a desert and there is scanty rainfall here. It is very far from the sea coast also. That is the reason there is low humidity here. It is very hot in summers and cold in winters over here.
And Kerala is a coast.
Yes, I remember we had studied in the chapter on heat about sea breeze and land breeze.
Yes, you are right. Due to the land and sea breeze, the weather in the places around the sea is always pleasant and there is a heavy rainfall too. We were in Jammu and Kashmir before moving to Kerala.
Wow! You have an experience of a lot of climatic conditions in the country.
Kashmir is situated in the mountains, hence it is very cold there.
Why don't we read in the atlas? Look here, they have shown the maximum and minimum temperatures of four regions of India in the summers from the year 2014.
Look, there is a lot of difference between the maximum and minimum temperatures of these four places.
It is written here that the pattern of weather of a place for over 25 years and the data collected for the same determines the climate of a place.
Yes, like the climate of Kerala, Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir and Rajasthan has been following a pattern for a number of years.
Like there is scanty rainfall in Rajasthan and it is extremely hot in summers. Hence, the climate is said to be hot and dry.
Yes, it rains most of the time in Kerala and it is mildly hot. That is why the weather of Kerala is hot and humid.
Let us watch the news in the evening today and listen to weather update. We will come to know about the climatic conditions in the different places in the country.
Look, Ramesh, the weather news reader is saying that it will rain in Kerala tomorrow. It will be very hot in Delhi and Rajasthan, and it will be mildly warm in Jammu and Kashmir.
If there are so many climates in our country, I wonder how many different climates will be there in the rest of the world.
Yes, right. You are right, Ramesh. Also think that when we move to one place from another, it impacts us in a huge way.
Yes, like Radha had to face a different climate.
Yes, Ramesh, like we wear light clothes in summers, woolen clothes in winters, and we take umbrellas in the rainy weather. Similarly, do the animals also get impacted with the changing weather and climate?
So, friends, weather tell us about the temperature, wind pattern and rain of an area for a few days. Climate is the weather pattern of a place for more than 25 years. But how do the animals and birds adapt themselves to the changing weather and climate? We shall learn about this in the next video. We shall meet soon. Adaptation in Animals, Part 3. Hello friends, how are all of you? We all stay at different places, like near the seaside, near deserts, close to the mountains, near the forests, in villages or in cities. Where we stay is known as our habitat. Man adapts himself according to the weather of that place and wears clothes accordingly, eats food according to the weather and keeps himself safe. Have you ever thought about how animals and birds adapt themselves? They also stay in different places like the forests, deserts, etc. Let us learn about the same through this video. The objectives of this story are 1. To understand why do animals adapt? 2. To understand how do animals adapt in different habitats.
Try and catch me.
Stop running now, Amar. We both are tired. Come, let us rest here.
Look, we did not realize we reached the pond while running.
Look, a frog.
Where? I cannot see one. Yes, there it is. Look how it is hiding amongst the green leaves.
Nature has provided animals with a lot of physical attributes to adapt to their surroundings, like this frog.
Yes, this is so unique. How do these animals and birds adapt themselves to the different weather conditions?
And which are those animals who adapt themselves? I remember reading that the animals who live in cold places and those who live in hot places adapt differently, like the camel adapts itself in a desert. But how do the animals who stay in cold places, like the polar bear and penguins, adapt themselves? It is extremely cold in the polar regions. I have read that the temperature drops down to minus 40 degrees Celsius. They cannot wear sweaters and socks like us.
Yes, we had studied in geography that it is very cold in the polar regions. Let us go home and try and read and find out more. Look at these pictures. There are pictures of polar bear and penguins here. Let us read. According to this, the polar bear A has white fur because of which it can mingle with the white snow and keep itself safe from the predators. B. There are two layers of hair on its body which keep him warm. C. Its nails are long and curved due to which it can walk easily on snow. D. It has a layer of fat under its skin which keeps it warm.
Wonderful! The polar bear can almost adapt with the help of all of these body parts.
It is written about the penguins that their skin is also thick, which keeps them warm, and they are excellent swimmers. Penguins are always found in groups so that they get warmth from each other.
This is very interesting information.
These animals adapt themselves in the cold weather for a long time, but a few birds also migrate, don't they?
Yes, when I had gone to meet my grandfather, who stay in Bharatpur, which is in Rajasthan, he told me that there are birds who fly for more than 15,000 kilometers to come there to migrate, like the Siberian crane, who migrates from Siberia to Bharatpur and return when the winter ends back home. It is amazing. How do these birds know the direction of Siberia to India?
I think they sense the direction from the sun and the moon. Let us go and ask Meena Didi. She studies in a college. I am sure she would know about migration. Hello Meena Didi, how are you? We all were discussing about adaptation of animals and birds. We were thinking that when birds migrate, how do they keep coming back to the same place? How do they remember the way?
Oh, that is great, children. It is a very interesting discussion. Actually, the thing is that majority of the birds migrate during the night. That is why we do not pay attention to their large groups flying at night. I'm sure there is something special in their structure which allows them to reach their destination without any map, etc. The scientists also still are not sure about the reason. There is evidence that birds also sense the gravitational pull of the earth to help in migration.
This is such an interesting information. I think we will have to ask a migratory bird one day about this.
I wish I had wings. Then I would have migrated like these birds and traveled the world.
Didi, we had read that the tropical regions are close to the equator. These places have rainforests. The weather is hot and humid, and there is abundant rainfall. a variety of animals like monkeys, gorillas, lions and colorful birds like parrots, etc. are found here. How do these animals adapt to the climate in the rainforest?
Yes, you are right. The animals and birds who stay in the rainforest have sensitive sense organs like sense of smell and sight, and they have a thick skin which helps them to camouflage easily.
Yes, like the monkey has a long tail which helps it to hang and grip on the branches of trees and can jump from one place to another.
Yes, and elephants have a long trunk which helps them use it to hold its food. Its tusks help in tearing bark off leaves which it loves to eat.
Wow, you are already know a lot. Do you know the elephant has very sensitive ears which help him to sense the slightest sound, and it can use them as a fan in summers. There is a bird known as toucan who has a large beak because of which it can reach fruits on weak branches.
Wonderful! Come Rama, Amar, let us go home and draw a picture and write the information on adaptation of animals and birds. We will show it to the teacher tomorrow. Thank you, Meena Didi.
So friends, hope you understood how animals adapt themselves to the different climatic conditions. Isn't it amazing? We should try and protect the habitat of animals. We shall meet soon.